Potters. So today I'm going to show you how to make a chip and dipper. And that's what I call plates with bowls in the center. They are totally one piece of clay and I throw them that way. So they're fun projects to do. They're a little bit of an intermediate to advanced project as far as teaching students is concerned, but it's fun to see what the possibilities are. So I'm using this piece is kind of a large piece, not quite as large as the plate I just showed you. Or larger rather than the plate I just showed you. This is probably about 4.5 to almost 5 pounds of clay. You certainly can make this project with much smaller amounts of clay, and then they might be for shrimp and shrimp cocktail, or in a previous video you may have seen an olive and pit dish, which is just a variation on it and much smaller. So I'm going to take this clay first, and when I'm using a lot of clay, I like to roll it around and create a little bit of a point at the bottom of that piece. So that, show you the profile, so that when I slam it down on the wheel, it suctions itself really nicely. In the past, I've found that when I don't do that, there's an opportunity for air bubbles to get stuck underneath that clay. So give it a good smack. Make sure it's attached to the wheel and we'll start the process. Put a little bit of water. And when I'm using larger pieces of clay, I use a method of centering called coning. I'm going to squeeze from opposite sides all the way up until I've created a nice cone shape with this clay. Gather a little bit more and lift that cone up a little higher. And then I'll use the traditional method of centering to press with my karate chopping hand back down. Make sure you use plenty of water when you're centering. There's no reason not to. It flies off the wheel really quickly, and if your hands are sticking, it just makes the process that much harder. So I'm using the heel of my hand now to dig into the center of that clay and draw the clay over to the opposite hand. I'm drawing in a diagonal over to the left-hand side. And this is helping me not only finish centering, but also flatten this piece out. Create the diameter that I'm looking for. And the diameter is really determined by the amount of clay that you put on the wheel. I bring mine out to about an inch or so, and I'm going to take this out a little further after I establish what's going to be the bowl in the center. So now I'm where I want to be to start working on the bowl. Slip off my hands. I've been throwing these for about an hour or so today already, so I'm filthy. And my clay is turning into mud. I'm going to go ahead and establish an area. I've left the area in the middle of this plate a little thicker so that I can go back and maneuver some clay into the bowl. So I'm just taking my sponge or my fingers and delineating a little bit of a moat, that this knob in the center will become the bowl. And then I'm going to take the rest of this clay and pull it back out so I can use it for the surface of the plate or the walls of the plate, wherever it lands. And I really like using the sponge for this because it's just applying water as I need it, and the pressure is more even than just using my fingertips. Just dragging that clay over to the edge of the wall of the plate. And it's really important when you're making flat surfaces to spend some time going back and forth over that surface to ensure that it's really flat and even, because the unevenness of the bottom of a piece of work is often what creates cracks later on, because as we all know, clay shrinks in the drying process. And any thin areas shrink first, and they tug on the areas that aren't thin. So now that I've got my plate somewhat established and my walls established, I'm gonna go back and tackle the bowl inside. So I'm just gonna flatten out the center with my sponge here, make sure that everything is incorporated. And then I'll go back to dig my bowl. I use several fingers to dig. You want to be a little bit alert to the fact that you're only trying to dig down to the level of the plate here, so that you've got the same thickness in the center of this form later on. Go ahead and spread this clay out into the rim. And then I'll come back with my outside hand and scoop up some of that exterior clay so that I have some wall clay here and start to bring up that bowl in the center. And this is just like pretending the plate isn't here and throwing a bowl. I'm just a little bit more cautious of where I'm squeezing at the base so that I don't make that area of the plate too thin. But I want to establish a decent sized bowl because this is going to be a really decent sized plate. And the bowl's a little thinner than I would prefer it to be, but they're different every time. Once I'm happy with that basic form, I can go back and fix the rim later on that plate, but I'm going to come back underneath and pull away any leftover clay so I can reestablish the nice flat surface of my plate. Sponge a couple of times, and then I'll usually switch over to one of my favorite mud tools here, the red rib tool. Super flexy bendy when they're red. The colors that these tools come in delineate how bendy they are or how flexible they are. So I really like the red ones. Get right under the rim of that or edge of that hole, clean everything up, really make sure that the surface of this plate is nice and flat and compressed, and also peels off the slip, which is nice because it helps sturdy up the clay a little bit quicker through the drying process when you get all the wet stuff off there right out of the gate. So I'm going to come back and just finish the rim of this bowl now that I'm done fiddling underneath it. And I use a thin little piece of chamois right here. I just soldered it over the rim. This is one of my favorite tools. It just creates a really soft rim or lip. And you don't have to apply too much pressure to soften things up. And then I'll come back and work on the rim to the plate. Put a little water there. Make sure my fingers don't stick. There's typically a really good amount underneath this edge of slip stuck there just from the making process, from the centering process. So I'll scoop that up. And then I'll go back and draw the edge of this plate over a little further. I don't like really tall rimmed plates. And there's a little bit more clay here than I would like to see. So that's why I'm kind of trying to increase the diameter a little bit. I'd rather have a wider serving surface than a decorative edge. But you can certainly do these more as bowl forms on the outside if you prefer. So now I'm going to scoop some clay up and draw this wall up a little bit. And I like to leave the rim of the plate a little thicker. That's just personal preference. And also for utilitarian functional work, it's just nice to have a thicker rim, less likely to chip when you're using it. Just bringing up this wall a little bit more until I'm happy with the amount of clay that's left. I go back in a couple more steps to finish up. And I'm going to take that rib tool again and come back in with the curved side of the tool just to hit the interior of this curved wall. And rather than fold the rim over like I would with a normal plate, I'm going to leave it sort of scooped in like this because the intent is that it's holding in whatever it is you're serving. It's easy to carry around that way without things sliding or rolling off. And then I'll come back with my angled knife and I'll come in at the side and just scoop away the clay that's not really part of my form. And set that in my slip container. This is also helping me run the wire under the piece when I'm ready to take it off, because even though I'm throwing on a bat, and I highly recommend making pots that are wider in diameter on bat surfaces so they don't have to be lifted off the wheel without a bat. And I'm going to come back around and just finalize the lip to this plate with my chamois. And then before I run the wire, I'll just clean up the surface of the bat that's visible. It makes it easier to clean later rather than having a bunch of dry clay stuck on there. Stop my wheel. I always undo my splash pan when I'm working on wider pieces. A lot of potters throw without a splash pan, and that's certainly an option. And then I'll use my wire, make sure it's firmly attached to that bat. And then I like to just pull with one hand. So I leave one hand stationary and I pull with the opposite hand until I get about 2/3 of the way under, and then I go ahead and finish up pulling with both hands. And so there you have it, a really grand chip and dip. If you try this project out, leave me a comment. Let me know what worked, what didn't work, or shoot me a picture. Certainly feel free to post on my blog as well at theveganpotter.com. Thank you so much. Have a great day.